very happy and a vibrant day. Myself, Sushmita Sahu. Today, I'm going to take a very interesting and very knowledgeable chapter. This knowledge should be there with each and every human being. This is wastewater story. That is, how do we reuse the wastewater? This is chapter 18 of class 7th with reference to NCERT. If you like the video, kindly subscribe for my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for further notification. So let's begin our journey. Wastewater, as the name suggests, or we can say, what is wastewater? See, thing is, the brown water that goes down the drains from sinks, showers, toilet, laundries is dirty. It is called wastewater. This wastewater should not be wasted. We must clean it up and use it. Now, how do we clean it up and how should we use it? This is what we are going to learn in this chapter. And as you all know, water is there for life. Like, you need to reuse your water. We have read in our previous chapters that the water table is reducing, the groundwater table is reducing, which has to be, we have to do rain harvesting and we need to increase that level and at the same time conserve water. We need to be very careful with the use of water. Now, how do we clean this water? Cleaning of water is a process of removing pollutants from it before it enters a water body or is reused. This process of wastewater treatment is commonly called as sewage treatment. It takes place in several stages. Now, we are going to learn these stages only. So, let's see. Now, sewage is wastewater released from by homes, industries, hospitals, offices and other users. It also includes rainwater that has run down the street during a storm or a heavy rain. The water that washes off roads and rooftop carries harmful substances with it, and these harmful substances are pollutants. Sewage is a liquid waste, most of its water which has dissolved and suspended impurities. These impurities are called contaminants. So, with this now, let us see what are sewers. We already know that, and we already see a network of big and small pipes, and these are called sewers, forming a sewerage. It is like a transport system that carries sewage from the point of being carrying sewage from the point of being produced to the point of disposal. That is the treatment plant. And now we will see about how it is cleaned. That is treatment of this polluted water. This is done in wastewater treatment plant, which is called WWTP. Wastewater is passed through bars of screens, large substances like rugs, sticks, cans, plastic packets, napkins are removed here. Now, wastewater goes to a grit and sand removal tank. The speed of the incoming wastewater is decreased to allow sand, grit and pebbles to settle down. The water is then allowed to settle in a large tank which is sloped towards the middle. Solids like feces settle at the bottom and are removed with a scraper. This is the sludge. A skimmer removes the float table solids like oil and grease. Water so cleared is now called clear water. And this is the way we clear the water. The sludge is transformed to a separate tank where it decomposes by an anaerobic bacteria. The biogas produced in the process can be used for electricity or can be used as a biogas also. And so now we need to become an active citizen. Now, how can we help? See, first thing is, do not throw, for better housekeeping practices, we need to be, do not throw everything in the sink. Cooking oil and fats should not be thrown in the drain. See, children, you are the citizens of tomorrow, so you need to take care of all this. The the cooking oil, it should not be thrown in the drain. They can harden and block the pipes. In an open drain, the fats clogs the soil pores, reducing the effectiveness in filtration. Now, and chemical like paint, solvents, insecticides, etc. should also not be thrown in a drain. Even the medical medicines, and there are many microbes which kill medicine waste, should not also be thrown in the drain. And used tea leaves, solid food remains, soft toys, cotton sanitary towels, etc. should not be thrown in the dustbin. These wastes choke the drains. They do not allow free flow of oxygen. This hampers the degradation process. And now we should know about proper sanitation, because if we don't have the proper sanitation, it leads to many diseases. And you all might be very aware that diarrhea, cholera, all these are caused by poor sanitation. So we should have nice sanitation. We should keep ourselves clean, keep washing your hand, cover your food. This is something now you all might be knowing. And now there are many alternative arrangements also for the sewage disposal in big cities. And we should maintain sanitation in the public places. It is our duty. It is not only the duty of government to keep cleaning things for you all. It is our duty to keep our things clean. And all these public places also belong to us. They are, these public places are meant for us only. When we use it, we need to keep it clean. We should not throw things here and there. Maintain proper sanitation, because sanitation, if you have proper sanitation, you are not going to be ill ever. So with this, I would like to thank you and would like to take a promise from you all that you will take care of Mother Earth and you will maintain proper sanitation and you will try not to pollute the water. With this, take care. Bye.